So we're going to try a little bit of animation now. So I've got a file here, which I'll distribute separately if you're in class. You see, when you open it, it just starts off kind of grey. Now, don't forget, up top right, click the rendered button, and then that will give us the light and the colours and so on. And what we're going to do is we're going to animate this snowball, hitting the snowman's head and hopefully knocking it off. Okay, so we're going to start just by zooming around on our snowman's head here. Now, at the moment, if we try and move these are all individual objects. Okay, so if we knock the snowman's head off, his hat and nose are going to stay where they are. So what we've got to do is we've got to connect them together. And we call this parenting, where we have an object and we connect it to another object. Okay, so all we do is I've just selected the head to start with. I'm going to go on the right hand side on object properties. Okay, and I'm going to give it a name just here. I'm just going to call it head. Okay, then I'm going to do the same with the hat. Okay, so it's called cylinder. I'm going to call it hat. And we're going to do the same with the nose as well. Okay. Nose. So we've now got some named parts of our model. Okay, you can see here on the right, we've got all the things in the scene. If we scroll down, we can see the things we've just labelled. Okay, so hat, head, and nose. Okay. And what we want to do is we want to join the hat and the nose to the head. So they kind of become one object. Now, all we do is, we see there we've got nose. If I hold down shift on my keyboard and keep it held down, drag it on top of head. Okay, you can see it says drop to set parent. All right, so that will mean now the nose is part of the head. Okay, you can see that there on the little down arrow. Now I'm going to do the same with hat. Hold down shift, drag on top of head. Okay. And if we look in head, you can see we've got hat and nose now. So these should hopefully be all one object. Okay. All right, there we go. See, they're all joined together. So we're going to start on the animation part of this now. Okay. So I'm just going to get the camera so I can see a couple of things here. There's our snowball. And I'm just going to move our snowball a little bit closer to the snowman. Say about there. Okay. So the way we animate in Blender is we use something called keyframing. Okay, keyframing. Now, traditionally in the past, we had stop frame animation where we would animate every single frame. So we'd have a model, we'd move it, take a frame, move it again, take another frame, and so on. Now, with keyframing, what we do is we tell the computer where we want an object to start, where we want it to end, and then the computer will add the frames automatically in between. Okay. It's called tweening. So what we're going to do is we're going to animate this snowball. It's going to tween from here to the snowman's head. Okay, so the way we're going to do this is we are going to start on frame one. Okay, and we're going to add a keyframe. So the way we do that is we've just got the snowball selected and we just press I on the keyboard. Okay, I. Insert keyframe menu, and we're going to get a load of options, and the one we want is this one: location, rotation, and scale. Okay, it's possible it may be abbreviated to log rot scale, but we're looking for that. Okay, so I'm just going to click there, and you can see I've got a little yellow diamond appear. All right, what I'm now going to do is I'm going to move to frame 20. Okay, and I'm going to move the snowball. So you see I've selected the frame first, then I'm going to move the snowball to where I want to hit the snowman, about there. Okay, and I'm going to repeat the same process. I'm going to press I and then click location, rotation, and scale. Okay, so far we've got the snowball starting at frame 0 over here and hitting the snowman's head at frame 20. Okay, so we can actually see that if we press the play button down here. Okay, so it's animated that for me. So I'm just going to move back to frame 20. Now what we want is the snowman's head flying off. Okay, so I'm going to click the snowman's head. Okay. And just as we did before, I'm going to press I to insert a keyframe. Okay. And I'm going to then move the snowman's head to where I want it to go. So let's say down here. Okay. So it's on the floor. And I'm just going to rotate it, so R to rotate, so it's going to face that way. Okay. And if it doesn't quite work as the way you want it, just press Control Z to go back. Okay. So, what have we got so far? Let's have a look. So, okay, so we've got there the snowball hitting the snowman's head. Okay. And actually, what I have done, I forgot to put the keyframe in. Okay, easily done. All right, so I'm going to go back to frame 20. We've got our keyframe. And I'm going to move the object. Sorry, again, a bit like I did before. Let's move it down like that. And put it tighter. Boom. Oh no, hang on, I've done this wrong again. I can't believe this. This is good practice, this, isn't it? Sorry. Okay, there we go. We're going to move the timeline first. Do as I say, not what I do. So move the timeline first to frame 40, and then we'll move the snowman's head. We'll get this right eventually. And there we go. And rotate. And then here is where we have the keyframe. Okay. All right, so let's have a look at what we've got. So we'll start at zero, hit play. Okay, cool, snowman's head falls off. Okay, so what I wasn't doing there, that second time, so you've got to move the timeline first. Okay, so move the timeline to the frame you want it, insert the keyframe, and go from there. Okay, so for example, if we then want like the snowball to fall off, so I'm gonna move the timeline, say, to 60, I'm going to move the snowball, let's have it kind of falling down here maybe, okay, and then I'm going to add my keyframing with I. Okay, so let's look at what we've got. Okay, cool. Now, we've just animated one thing at a time here. Now, you could actually animate more than one thing. You could have like snowballs coming from different directions, if you like. So have a little go at that, okay? Remember to parent the hat and the nose and head together, and maybe see if you can get a couple of snowballs going, all right? Or maybe even, depending on how creative you're feeling, you could sort of get the snowman's head going into a tree and maybe turning into a big splatter of snow, okay? So have a go at keyframing and tweening and see how you get on.